Actually, I just want to tell you the background that when this idea of inclusive manufacturing and before that distributed manufacturing was promoted by Professor Baldev Raj, he took me to UK and then in Cambridge as well as in Royal Academy of Engineering. There were a lot of discussions, and from that many newer ideas has come up. So primary aim of this kind of forum which we envisage is to integrate the people, society, as well as industry and new innovators to go ahead with the many ideas which are going to create value and then promote the concepts. So what I noticed that there are one-sided where, say, for example, some new products are coming up, but a lot of things to be learned from the established industry also, that what are the things they are doing actually which can be imbibed in developing the new product and its manufacturing base. So this example starts from one of the projects that we and myself and our students were doing with respect to the pipeline. This pipeline was product of American company, and they have given it to one of the giants in India, and they uploaded it to a very small company in the Devas. They don't have any background of how the ultrasonic welding can be used or laser welding can be used to create big pipes for handling nuclear waste. So people were untrained. They were making the pipe in a very wrong manner. The result was 40% to 50% rejects. And then we thoroughly studied that process, and then we found that how these rejects can be come down to 10%, and then that led to the my what you call study of all type of pipes. And why pipes? Pipes were basically all kind of household, villages, towns, cities, everywhere you can find that there are pipes. And there is a lot of scope for new entrepreneurs to come into this industry, and maintenance, repair, etc. is keep on going on actually. But we have to learn many lessons also from the previous failures of other kind of similar industry which were not only targeting our needs but also targeting the needs of the other country. And one among them was carpet actually. So we come from Eastern UP, and there is a hub of carpet actually. You remember that Bhadohi area is known for carpet industry, but that has got many setback because of the many issues that has come up internationally, particularly socially and environmental sides, child labor, the pollutions, etc. So how to carry out those things and then build up a platform which can help actually to manufacture these pipes and also find out the faults, defects, etc. in a digital platform manner actually. So that is the basic aim. Just quickly I want to rush through that, but my main idea is to link this particular process of manufacturing and lesson learned and how digitally this can be carried out, so that it not only pipe, it can also be scaled up to the many other products where many assemblies are involved. So as you can see that there are different sectors where pipe can be used. So it's like say oil and gas, non-oil, then transport sector. So many sectors where this can be used, so I'm not going to list on that. And there are some popular methods of manufacturing pipes, like say electric resistance welding, helix strong, some submerged arc welding, longitudinally submerged arc welding, ductile cast iron, and many other methods which are there. And there are different sizes of the pipes which can be manufactured by different material, and what are the raw material processes and key difference and applications that we have noted down, that how it can help actually to make different kind of pipes. And this is the whole manufacturing process that are standardized one and mostly used for different kind of pipe, right from the heating, piercing, mandrel mill, cooling, stretch producing, reducing, heat treatment, sawing, and etc. So all these steps, they are being used primarily in manufacturing the pipes. Somewhere some is skipped also, but most more or less it is followed actually. Now coming up, for such a kind of things, it is not manufactured by bigger companies. There are small companies, they are also playing a role. But these companies, we wanted to help through this framework that how can they standardize it. Otherwise, you make your own pipe which is selling only in few parts, not standardized, cannot be interchangeable. So in order to bring those interchangeable concept and also fitting into the some other cultural needs, you have to need experts like China having expert to capture our sari and other things. Similarly, we have to capture their needs. So we want all this RP group and layered manufacturing group and design group to have many startups that can, their job is only to capture the needs of the consumers of different places, different country, and then they translate that idea to tell our small manufacturers that what, because small manufacturers cannot have access to the very costly softwares that are required to convert a perfect design. So they need to follow this kind of cloud-based structure, or cyber-physical-based structure, actually to have some SMEs or some sort of startups who can train these small manufacturers to create the network of pipe manufacturing, actually. And then we need people who can pack and logistic providers to make the whole platform operating, actually. And this framework, we have take care of right from the customer request, then design, then manufacturing and logistics, as you can see. And how something which is not being manufactured, how can we re-enter into the model so that that particular design specification can be reiterated and can manufacture. And then there are different guidelines which need to be followed, and how the information sharing among the different partners can be made possible. And based on that, we can see that these manufacturers, they can get the all the design information and then find out the what are the loopholes, and then back and forth information sharing can further improve the product, actually. And similar ways with the logistic providers, that what are the different needs and color codes and services that are needed by the different countries. Otherwise, same phenomena may happen, that one particular big consignment of around $40,000 reached to the place. They mentioned that this particular consignment is having more what you call lead in the color, and that particular information was not translated to the local manufacturers, and because of that, again similar kind of consignment has gone and rejected. So logistics, this must be fully translated to the manufacturing sites also. And based on that whole model which we have thought for pipe, that can also be extended actually for different product assemblies, where you can see the product design and then process, how the process can be specified, how this platform can be intervened, and different kind of specifications that require, that must be taught, so that any person who is new, he is following a small procedure or some unique procedure, let him get converted into a standardized procedure which can help him actually to reduce the cost of their item. And then this is very generic product process and service platform which they have to follow actually in order to be competitive, in order to be responsive with respect to different legislations and measures. And normally this is the bigger framework of digital platforms where we want to link the design, manufacturing, services with a proper database, and then all these knowledge, particularly about the design, manufacturing, services, they need to be coded. And the last block that you can see here, this block is very interesting block, where idea is, last block, like say, we have very local innovations, like police, they still use a process we call it dust numbering. That dust numbering process means every local police stations, you can find out that there is a list of the people who have earlier committed some crime actually. So with that particular dust numbering list, they catch hold of the people and they inquire with them and they use their own process, and then they track the criminals. So even a new product, this particular methodology is called hot spot actually, which is very popular now, gaining in multidimensional scaling, and also along with many fault analysis and fault diagnosis technique, they are now trying to find out the faults and also complete what you call new product development, where the fault, whether in the service sector or in manufacturing or in design, that can be located quickly, so that product will be free from any defect and it will be acceptable in the market. Now question is, from looking it seems that very costly, it requires this kind of net, that kind of cost support software. No, when we propose this cloud-based architecture, that SME group, it is their job actually to make this thing available, and many countries it is doing, particularly the, I'm concluding. So many countries are doing that. It is, and those, they are creating more values, they are creating more employment, and they are making their industry socially relevant. So my whole theme of presentation is the inclusive manufacturing should consider the existing beer manufacturers and their way of incremental improvements in their product, also promote newer developments, smaller component products, and let them scale it up to the higher level, and use all such kind of known platforms to improve the product design and help the manufacturers, help the designers, help the entrepreneurs to scale up their products. Thank you, sir.